from the Christmas room, Peter Gregg and Jingle Bells. This is Jingles, my little puppy. He's kissing me. Yuck. But anyway, we both wanted to say hello. Today, what are we going to talk about? We're going to talk about codecs. What is All-I, IPB, MJEP? What is that about? I'll be right back.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
I got my trusty whiteboard because we're going to use it today. Okay, let's see. You have the Canon 5D Mark IV, which is causing a big uproar because of its codec with when you shoot in 4K. Codec execution. So what is that about? How is it executing the code of recording what we're doing? So this one here, let's start at the top. Canon, I'm shooting with the Canon 5D Mark IV. I've got the 24mm f1.4 lens. I'm shooting at 1080 this time instead of 4K. Now, when you go to 1080, not only in the Canon, but you've got it in most of the newer Canons. You've got it in the Panasonic GH4. You've got it in most of their cameras. You've got it in the Sony's. So what is All-I and IPB mean? Why did Canon put MJPEG in here? What's the reasoning? What do all these things do? So, anything pertaining to this particular video, I'm putting the information down below. So the color balance was done with a custom white color balance with a better white balance. That's the name of this tool. I created it. I'm its daddy. Hey, I'm your daddy. So that's down below at petergregg.com. In the Peter Gregg's toolbox is a listing of what the sound is and everything pertaining to this video. I'm just saying that because people sometimes write and say, what did you do here? What did you do there? And I go, I don't remember. I mean, ten videos ago, I don't remember. So I started writing it down and I put it in the information box or whatever you call that, description box down below. So now we're shooting 1080p and the focus is being done by dual pixel focus with face recognition means that it's following my face. If I turn to the right or turn to the left, somehow Canon does it really good and it works. So I don't have to do a pre-focus and all that kind of good stuff. So now down to business. What the heck is IPB? We've got IPB. You got I. Nice, huh? I learned in school. Kindergarten, actually. P. B. Now, contrary to popular belief, this has nothing to do with peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. Okay? I want a PB and J. That's got nothing to do with it. Okay? So IPB is one of the codecs. Then you have, it's easier for me to write this way, all I. You got that choice. What does that mean? I don't know. Look on page 5. It's not really there. Okay. Then you've got M, J, P, E, G. M, JPEG. Okay, so you've got those choices. This one compresses the least, meaning you get the largest file that's written on your card. This one compresses more than this one, and this compresses the most. Do you care? Well, if you care, let me tell you why it should mean something to you. These affect the quality of your videos, whether you're shooting 1080p, 720. I'm not sure what all happens in 4K because they don't give you these distinctions in 4K. But in 1080p, which is what I'm shooting now on my Canon 5D4, I have it set to all I. Now, why? All right. Well, as soon as you press the shutter, to start recording a film, a movie, a video, okay, you get your very first image. Ta-da! Now, there's a whole bunch more that follow. Okay, that's what happens when you record video, right? You get all these frames. And you know how you flip a deck of cards or something, and or somebody does like a sketch drawing on a piece of paper, and they start flipping it, and then it almost looks like the man's hand is moving, and that's called animation. And this is what's happening when we're watching videos. We're doing animation. You didn't know you were an animator, did you? Okay, so the very first frame on this system, and this system is a very full, complete frame. It's all about itself. It doesn't need anybody else. It can live on an island, and we're going to call that the iframe, or they call that the keyframe, because everything operates off of this for some of these. Okay? Now, this is how we're going to start putting this to make it understandable. Now, this iframe is a complete frame. If I took a picture of you, by the way, you look very nice today. Your hair done very nicely. Okay. You shave. Make sure you get all these little ones underneath your chin. Okay. So, this is a complete frame. Now, the other side, that got to get that one hair that's hanging out. Okay. That's a complete frame. So, if I take a picture of you, it's going to have that one hair that's sticking out. Okay. Now, if you don't move an inch, but somebody walks over to you and cuts off that hair off of your face. But don't move. You're frozen. The background is frozen. The Christmas room, everything is frozen. This is the next frame, and this frame is called the P frame. The P frame looks at this frame and says, what's different about it? We're only going to record what's different, and we're going to make up the rest. We're going to fake it. You know how when you go to bed with someone, never mind. It's going to be a fake image. It's going to take what's here. It's going to compare. It's going to take all this time to do it, too. It's going to compare what's going on between here and here, okay? And it's going to make up an image out of nowhere. That's it. It's a fake image. That's the IPB. So what's the B? The B looks back to see what's the same between the B and the P, the same thing that the P did with the I, but it will also look forward to see, because it's going to start all over again with an I, and it's going to go IPB, IPB. Go ahead, make a rap song out of that, okay? IPB, IPB, don't you be, I see you be, whatever. All right, so now this one here is going to compare this one and this one. And it's going to make up an image. And when it's done, then the next image that's made up starts all over with a keyframe again, a fresh whole frame. Now, all I... Are you getting it? Are you getting it? Are you getting the secret here? All I means that every one of these are eyes. They're all individual frames. All by themselves. Where IPB, this one's made up, this one's made up, you get a real one. Then that one's made up, that one's made up, you get a real one. Ta-da-ta-da-ta-da, ta-da-ta-da-ta-da, ta-da-ta-da-ta-da. Ta-da-ta-da-ta-dam. Everybody together. Ta-da-ta-da-ta. Okay. All right. So that's what IPB means. So why are they doing all that nonsense? That's because they're compressing. They're making smaller files. So when you got a little camera, you want to make smaller files. So when you load them up, we put them up on the internet. So you get the smaller files because it makes up files in between this iframe and this iframe. But when you go to all I, that means they're all I's. They're all keyframes. Boom, 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 boom. So what is a JPEG? The MJPEG is this iframe is actually a JPEG, JPG image. And so is this one, and so is this one, and so is this one. So this is just a bunch of JPEG images. Now that's called a codec. This is called a codec because what it does is its own thing. It takes a bunch of JPEGs. You ever hear those cameras that go? Well, that's what's happening when you're shooting MJPEG. Every one is a pristine key image. Each one is compressed by itself. It's got nothing to do with this guy. It's like neighbors that will never speak to each other. Don't even want to look. They you know, like horse blinders. This way and this way. I don't care what this image is doing. So the MJPEG is giving you pristine, or the best that you can get for that camera, JPEG images, a bunch of them in a row. Very much like that flipping of the cards, okay, where it becomes an animation. So this is a bunch of JPEGs, okay? Now these, they take about 15 images in a row and they group them together and it's called a group of images. And then it compresses this whole bunch so that this way it makes a smaller file. This one, it just compresses every JPEG along the way. That's the MPEG right here. Okay. Hey, why aren't you writing? Okay, that's the plus. So it would be a complete JPEG image. And each one is compressed as if you took the pictures one at a time all by yourself. So if you go out with your friends and you take 40 pictures, you've got 40 JPEGs. If they were actually shot in a row, you could actually turn it into a movie. So the theory is you can extract any one of these JPEGs and you have an 8 megapixel, which is what 4K is, 8.7 something, it's 8.8, we'll make it better, okay? So each one is an 8 megapixel camera. Remember how we used to have 4 megapixel cameras and then we went to 6 and then we got 8 megapixel cameras and then, oh my God, they went to 10 and 12 megapixels. We were in heaven. Now we got 30 megapixels, okay? So each one of these on the MJPEG is a complete compressed image all by itself. Now on the all I, you go like, well, why isn't all I good? Well, it is. Actually, all of these are good, all right? But like I said, each one compresses it to a smaller file. However, you can't even apply the word smaller to MJPEG. That's just a freaking huge file, okay? I've experienced it. It makes it a drag. It's like carrying around two suitcases that's got 50 pounds each. At some point, you're going to get tired of it, okay? So it takes a bunch of these images and then compresses them. Now, what's inside is either all I's, which is the I, and it takes that batch and compresses them, okay? Or it takes the IPB, which it starts with a fresh, pristine image. The next one makes one up all by itself off of this one. Then this one looks back at this one and makes another one up. So you got fakers in here, all right? I'm using stronger words because I want you to understand what's happening. These two are fake images. They don't exist. They're actually working off of this image and this image, which are your keyframes. Now the all I, they're all keyframes, but it's still taking the whole batch and compressing it. This one is compressing this one, then it's compressing this one, then it's compressing this one, compressing this one. These are true JPEG images that are just going on in a row. So I'm now shooting with this one because I want the best quality. Isn't this marker going to work? What is wrong with this marker? This video is being shot in 1080. And all I. Meaning that for this video, I have an I, a complete image, an intra image, which means everything's in itself. And then another intra image, which everything's in itself. Another intra image, everything's in itself. Another image, everything's in itself. Okay? So that's what all I is. Now, if I had set the camera to IPB, I'd get an even smaller file, but I would get a lower level quality. So that's my explanation. Did you like it? Jingle Bells fell asleep over here. He didn't like the explanation. He fell asleep. So here's the thing. If you want to, take a snapshot of this And you can explain it to somebody else when they go, what's IPB? And what's all I? What's the difference? And you go, I don't know. Who cares? Just shoots the videos, right? So that's it, guys. This is Peter Gregg, live from the Christmas Room. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Thank you to my subscribers. Everyone that has clicked the button that says subscribe, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Peter thanks you. Peter thanks you. Peter thanks you. Peter thanks you. I'm grateful, okay? That's the point here. That's it. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Anything else I need to tell you? No. Everything's down below. Click on something. Oh, the white balance tool. Buy it. It's to help support my my site here, some a little income, you know, and you get a great white balance tool. The best there is, actually, but that's in my opinion. All right. Live from the Christmas Room. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.
Okay, Jingles, another baby. Come here. Come on. Come on. Another. Yes. Hey, it's Peter Gregg. And come here. I guess he doesn't want to come. Oh, he does want to come. He's afraid. He's afraid. Because this is Jingles time in the video. And what is this? What is that? Huh? And here's another one. Those are markers. See, that's my fingerprint. You're not going to like the smell of that. Did you tell everybody that you're nice and clean today? Well, that's me and Jingles saying goodbye. Thanks for watching. Oh, we always put Jingles at the end of the videos now. It's just a little extra bonus. Nothing to do with the videos. Nothing to see here. Go, 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 go. Just Jingles and I are having a little talk. Those are all my subscribers and viewers. Yes. They like watching us. They certainly do. Yes, they do. All right, let's go turn off the camera. All right, that's it, folks. Time to turn the camera off. Bye.